What up, what up, what up, what up? Hey, it's your boy E.T. Welcome to another edition of, that's right, T-G-I-T. Now look, I gotta be real with y'all, all right? So I'm reading this article the other day. I'm on Twitter, first of all. I don't know how I got to the article, right? Somebody linked the article to me. I'm reading the article and I'm going through it. Now y'all know, every week I'm trying to come to my students, right? And I'm trying to equip you. First of all, I'm trying to get you to understand that school is serious. Are you hearing what I'm saying? A lot of y'all going to school and y'all don't see the connection. Like, for real, you think learning is, you know, it ain't cool, all right? You don't understand, for real, that wherever you're trying to get to in life, all roads, you got to go through school, right? School lead to every single road. So I know you're not interested in school, but are you interested in life? Are you, for real, you say you want to be a baller. You can't be a true baller without reading. All right, now watch this, y'all, because y'all don't know. Tupac, that's right, went to a performing arts school. He wasn't a dummy. And all y'all look up to Lil Wayne, and y'all don't realize that Lil Wayne had honors classes in high school, right? I know you didn't know that, right? So Lil Wayne, contrary to popular beliefs, my man's not dumb, all right? My man has a very high IQ. So when I read this, I'm just going to be real with y'all. I was stressed. I was struggling. I'm going through it. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to do what most people don't do. When they read stuff about you, right? They don't share it with you. They just judge you. So I'm going to share it with you because I'm hoping it's a misprint. Like, for real, I'm hoping this ain't real. All right? But if it is, and if it applies to you, I'm going to need you to, look, step your game up. All right? I need you to turn it all the way up. I'm going to need you to get your weight up academically because I know you could do it. So real quick, you got to go on Wall Street Journal, and it says SAT scores fall as more students take the exam. Now, I'm just going to read the first part for you because it blew my mind. It says, as it related to the SAT scores for high school graduating class of 2012. Hey, 2012, y'all out there, y'all got to take this one personal for me. All right, watch what it says. It says that y'all fell in two of the test three sections, right? With reading dropping to the lowest level in four decades. Are you hearing me? Like, for real. And you guys did so bad, like the scores hadn't been as bad in four decades. Like, you gotta take that personal. And then when I looked down, I thought this part was deep too. It says out of 1.66 million schools, private and public schools throughout the country, only 43% of y'all are ready to go to college. Like, for real. Now, okay, all right. And one last part, when you get to it, this is the part that hurt me the most. And I'm just gonna read it. It says Latino and African-American students posted lower average scores than white and Asian students. Like, come on. Like, I'm hoping this is a misprint. But I'm going to need you, if you out there and this applies to you, I'm going to need you to step your game up. I'm going to need you to get your weight up. All right, so I got three quick principles, right? Just in case this is real, all right? This is for all my students out there. Number one, now, we got that Rams pride here, all right? Listen to me, Doc, they got that Rams pride. When you walk through the school, I mean, you see it. You see that burgundy, you see that Ram. Like, they got Rams pride here. They doing it big.
Palm Beach Lakes High.
So my first principle is, at some point in life, you gotta have pride, man. You gotta take ownership. You gotta take pride in where you come from, who you are. Like, right, for real, your family last name, right? You gotta rep. Y'all talking about, I rep hard for my city. Listen to me, you just can't rep on the football field. You can't just rep on the basketball field. You just can't rep in the weight room. You can't, tennis, volleyball. You listen to me, we are a world power. We just can't rep in the U.S. Olympics. We just can't rep in basketball. We can't just rep in swimming. We rep hard, academically as well. So listen to me, you gotta take pride in every part of your life. Academic pride, listen to me, whatever your hand find to do, you got to do it with all your might. Everything you do, you got to do it with a spirit of excellence. So if you're going to go to class every day, if you're going to come to class, if you understand what the teacher said, if you can read the textbooks, I'm going to need y'all to step up. SAT scores, reading, writing, at the lowest it's been in four decades. Come on, 2012. Y'all got to step up for me. So 2013, 2014, 2015, I'm going to need y'all to change that for me, all right? I'm going to need y'all to bring those scores up. But the first thing you got to do for me is you got to have pride, guys. Y'all see me when I travel. Normally, I'm rocking that Detroit Tiger hat. Why? Because I'm trying to let people know where I'm from, and I'm trying to let them know I rep hard for my city. If I can come out of Detroit and do the things I'm doing, You guys can do the same thing. The reason why I'm wearing New York today is because I'm rocking this hip-hop shirt. And y'all know where hip-hop started, in New York, so I'm repping. I need you, when you go to class, take pride. Listen to me, just like, again, when you hooping, you got that mean crossover, I need you to be able to cross over in the classroom. Bilingual, baby, the crossover. You speak two languages and you speak them fluently. Y'all living in a different era, are you hearing what I'm saying? I need that pride, that Rams pride, are you hearing me? So you gotta hear what I'm telling you, you gotta take pride. So when you're taking that spelling bee, you're taking that spelling test, when you're doing that world history exam, when you're doing geography, I need you to come in there just like in basketball, you ain't gonna let nobody hold you. Just like in basketball, you trying to take it to the rack. When it's time for the spelling, I need you to raise your hand and I need you to say, I'm about to blow this test out the water. So number one, I need you to take pride. Number two, I need you to compete. Listen to me, every time you come to class, I don't want you sitting in the back chilling. Raise your hand, get involved, sit up front, get there on time, sit up front, bring your book bag. Listen to me, just don't come, don't just bring your body language when you walk in the classroom. I want, like you're doing basketball, you got the gear on, you got the J's on, you got the wristband, you got the armband, you got the full gear on. My man walk in, you looking at my man like, you don't want none of this. Flat out, you're not playing basketball timid, you're not playing basketball passive. You're not on the football field passively. You're ready to compete. When you walk in that classroom, don't be afraid because it's academics. Don't be scared. Listen, I'm embarrassed. SAT scores dropped. Do y'all know what that means? We're competing globally, right? Y'all competing. You need a 3.5, a 4.0 now if you want to compete globally. You just ain't competing against people in Florida, in Michigan, in Illinois, in California. Because of the internet, guys, this thing has gone global. Are you hearing me? So I need y'all to compete. When you show up, you don't show up to take an L. You don't show up to take an L in football, in basketball, in baseball, in boxing. You don't come to take an L. You bring 120%. Why? Because you want to win. Listen to me. They giving out A's. I don't want to hear that C stuff no more. I don't want to hear that D stuff no more. I don't even want to hear B's. You had a potential to be a straight A student. Act like it. All right, so number one, baby. Number one, I need that pride, that Rams pride. Number two, I need you to compete. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? And my final one, guys, listen to me very closely. I need you to go hard or go home. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Go hard or go home. You say, Eric, what does that mean? I need you to come in with the eye of the tiger. When you come to school, bruh, I need you focused like, yo, this is just, listen to me, this is just the beginning. I ain't finished at high school. I ain't finished at college. Some of y'all gonna write books. Some of y'all gonna be doctors. Listen to me, I need you to go hard. What do I mean? I need you to stop just thinking about today as if today is the only day. Look, what you are to be, guys, for real, you're now becoming. So when you go to the class, you gotta come with it. Like for real, you gotta take that math book and be aggressive about it. You can't just say, all right, teacher told me to read chapter one. No, you read chapter one, read chapter two, go to chapter three. You come back in the class and you let your teacher know I already did one. I'm up on that. You taking notes. Are you getting with your friends that study? You getting with the teacher, right? You going online. You looking at the study guide online. You going hard to go home. For real, go hard. Stop being passive. I want you to go 120%. I know you could do better academically. I know you can get an A in that writing class. I know you can get an A in that literature class. I know you can get an A in geometry, in algebra, in calculus. You playing with it, though. You playing with it. You playing with it. All right? So I need you to go hard or go home. One more time, baby. One more time. I'm hurt. These SAT scores don't represent us. If that's what we could do, and listen to me, Latino, African-American students, I'm just saying, they call y'all out. Is it the real deal, Holyfield? I don't know. I have not had time to really dive into the research and investigate the research. I don't know if it's empirical data or not, but I do know they wrote about you. So I'm saying if you Latino, you African-American, I want you to prove them wrong. Make them a believer, not just athletically, but academically, make them a believer. So where that pride at? I need that pride, all right? I need that pride. When you walk in, you represent a beautiful country. You represent a culture. Right? An ethnic background. You represent your family. You represent your community. Where's your pride? When you get a C, come on. You get a D, that's not rapping. All right? You hear what I'm saying? I need you to rap. All right. Number two, listen to me very closely, guys. When y'all go in that classroom, man, for real, I need you to compete just like you do on the field. All right? I want you to, till the clock is on zero, you playing that game. All right, you playing that game until the buzzer sounds. I need you to do the same thing. And then finally, I need you to go hard or go home. Don't come in here. Don't come in here with that half effort no more. Don't come in here with 75% effort. Don't even come in here with 90%. I want you to give them 120%, and I want the class of 2013 to prove that this is wrong, that the SAT score, this is wrong. We do better than that on standardized tests. I don't care if it's homework. I don't care if it's a test. I don't care what it is. We better than that. And I want you to prove to the world that y'all better than that. Hey, it's your boy E.T. saying if it was easy, everybody would do it. Without struggle, there is no progress. But if you apply yourself, can't nobody hold you. If you apply yourself, can't nobody stop you. If you apply yourself, you can have, you can be, and do whatever you want. So do me a favor. Do me a favor. Stop bringing half effort and give me all you got. It's your boy E.T. Some of you in class, you putting up D's. That ain't you. No. You got C minuses. That ain't you. Some of y'all got B's. That ain't you. I need y'all to do me a favor. I need y'all to give me the best that you got. You understand me? I need you to give me the best that you got. I need you to give me 120%. I need you to get in the game, baby. You don't like sitting on the bench in basketball or football. Why are you sitting on the bench in school? I need you to get in the game. When a teacher writing stuff on the board, I need your hand raised like I got that one. It's an algebraic equation. I got that one. Give me the marker. No, are you hearing what I'm telling y'all? In basketball, you want the rock. You want the rock in basketball. You like, coach, he's a ball hog. He's not passing the ball. I want it. Right? I was funny. It was at a soccer game the other day with my goddaughter. She's only 6 years old. The coach was about to call my goddaughter and like, come on in the game. And another little girl got up and just like, I'm getting in. Hey, coach didn't know what to do. They 6 years old. He couldn't make the 6-year-old sit down. Homegirl just got up and got right on there. But my goddaughter, no points were scored. She scored the only one. I was like, see, you should have brought her here earlier. Right? But she wanted to be in the game. I need you to do me a favor. Black men, Latino men especially, because of where we are. The next time the teacher has an algebraic equation and she say, I need help, you jump up and say, give me the pen. A squared. Plus B squared. Equals C squared. And then you just break the whole thing down. For real, swag. And when you finish with it and you get it right, just drop the marker.